Now, at the State of the Union, we want to bring you up to the date on some of the things that are going on for you to check out. Tonight only, you can purchase season tickets and receive a discount of $50 per seat. See a ticket sales rep on the concourse, talk to them about the full and half season options, as well as the Flex 12 ticket plan offer. The Pro Shop available to you to pre-order the new, you heard about these, haven't you? National Good at Your Home and Road jerseys. If you pre-order one, you can get a new logo hat and t-shirt for just $25. All retro, that is now retro logo merchandise, is on sale. And season ticket holders can save up to 60% off selected items with your season ticket holder ID badge. Fifth Third Bank, by the way, is committed to growing their businesses, creating best-in-class franchises, and doing their part to contribute to the enrichment of the community. That's why we're extremely proud to introduce Fifth Third Bank's National Creditors Checking, Credit, and Debit Cards available for you effective July 27th. Fifth Third Bank's booth is next to the Pro Shop. Be the first to see the creditors' new checking, credit card, and debit cards. While you're there, you can sign up for a free Pro Shop gift card for $200. Our city, our team, and Fifth Third must be your bank, the fans' bank, Fifth Third Bank. As always, remember, FDIC. Now we'd like to welcome some of the National Creditors Cancer veterans. These ladies have done over 125 community appearances throughout the season. Many of those including charitable causes and hospital visits as well. Let's take a look at some of what they have been doing within the community. On the penalty box side, we greet the members of the media here this evening. Never have we done a better job with the penalty boxes than we have here tonight. So, thank you for coming in here and covering the action here tonight. Now to introduce our town hall panel, we will go from your left to right as we have the Creditors Chief Operating Officer, Sean Henry. Creditors Head Coach, Barry Trotz. Creditors Owner and Chairman, Tom Ciggaran.
Had a great year too, the best year in the franchise's history. won more playoff games, advanced in the second round. The number of firsts in the team. What they did is tangible evidence of many years of solid work and the fact that this ownership group is committed to, again, establishing the Nashville Predators as an elite National Hockey League team. We're confident that we're on the right track in the locker room, workout facilities for our players. They got a chance to see them. We're second to none now. They were second to worst probably before last year. We got Mike Fisher in February. That move was calculated to get us farther along toward the Stanley Cup, and it certainly did. And we are projecting that this year's payroll will be the highest in franchise history, higher than next year. The ownership group is committed to continuing to invest in this team. We invested in this franchise and this community to make sure that the special moments that we all as fans experienced last year would continue to occur for years to come. I don't know how many of you actually saw it on television or were there in person, but the scene at the signature terminal when the team plane came back from Vancouver, there were hundreds of fans lined up through the terminal, out across the road, to the parking lot, to welcome the team home. No publicity about it, nothing, just spontaneous action. It was really amazing. And also the moment in the playoffs in our first round, David Legault scored the net goal. We were sure that we clinched the first round series. That was an amazing moment as well. So to you, the fans, on behalf of ownership, staff, and players, thank you for your passion. Thank you for your support. Given the progress made in the last 12 months, we're excited about doing even more next season. Go Preds!
We also thought we had a good goalie in Anders Lindback, but we weren't sure of that. So The game plan and the variable analysis is we thought we'll run with Pekka for the first 20 games and we'll see how good he is and we'll go from there. Well, as luck would have it, Pekka was hurt the first game of the season. Anders Lindback, who's never played in the NHL, gets played in the first game. Then he has to go to the United Center in Chicago against the Stanley Cup champions. Lo and behold, the Stanley Cup champions are dead. Solly went down again, Pekka missed some more games, but we found a way. Our coaching staff did a marvelous job, and our players competed night after night. And as Tom said, a crucial point in the season was near the trading deadline when ownership allowed us to make a trade for Mike Fisher, and that was a big trade for us this year, and it's going to be a huge trade for us going forward. Trotz was up for the second year in a row for the coach of the year.
Coming into the trading deadline, I mean, end up playing the top four right away.
he's a terrific player, going to play more situations. He's going to find it steady and great on the coming field. This year, you're going to see it at the training camp. Some really young guys playing for a team. You've heard a lot about Brian Ellis, our first round draft just a few years ago. He's a guy that, again, we talked about when we drafted him. Is he going to be a specialist, or is he going to be special? This guy is an unbelievable type of player. He's not the biggest guy, 5'9", 5'10". But his vision, his offensive abilities, this kid is, you do a lot of things. He might be a little bit of an antidote to a power play that we need to perk up a little bit. Roman Josi, the player from Switzerland that been down in Milwaukee this year. I know Barry will talk about him a little bit. He's a terrific player, terrific vision. Matthias Ekholm from Sweden was a rookie here in the Swedish league. These are all good players. I have no worries for our defense for now or for the future. We have that covered. The area that seems to talk about the most with Predators is our forwards. And I think it's somewhat unfair. From a starting point, we're going to have Mike Fisher for a full season. His not only his play, but his leadership is going to be valuable for us. And basically, he played without a number one center for three quarters of the season. With Fisher being in that position, I think we're going to be in great shape. We've got the veterans in Erad and May, Smithson. Even Bert Truth now, he's 28 years old, he's a veteran. So, but where I really want to talk about, and what I really think is underestimated in our team, the rest of our forwards, is the potential of forwards and how young they are. Patrick Hornquist went from 30 goals a year ago down to 21 goals. He's 24 years of age. Sergei Vasilyevsky, the bargain of the year last year.
Our target is 25 this year. Don't put that on the tape, will you? You see him counting down and counting down. Our goal is 25 shutouts this year, building on the 16 last year. It's an aggressive goal, but it's one I think we're up for. David did a great job. David Strong did a great job in interacting with the National Hockey League. We have 15 Saturdays this year, and we've got some marquee games in and around Thanksgiving and Christmas. We'll actually play our thousands game on November 16th against the Montreal Canadiens. Nothing happens until the building's built. And one of the first things me and Sean did last year was we gathered everybody in a room and we said, we know you have day jobs, but we want to teach you how to sell tickets because we're going to fill this building. And, you know, selling tickets, you get selling tickets, and our players will tell you, the excitement in the stands turns into better on ice performance, which turns into wins, which sells more tickets, allows us to reinvest back into the team and pick up Mike Fisher's, and we'll be very nimble this year in February as well as David and Tom said. So that's probably the first primary point. On the second point, we also try to attract corporate sponsors to our organization. This year, we were able to partner with Fifth Third as our official bank, and I think it's as Pete said, we're coming out with Predator checking and Predator credit cards, and we're in the process of working up. If you get one of those cards and you use it at our concession stands, or you use it to buy tickets, you're going to get some value added. And that's a work in progress. We also signed AT&T, was another big addition that we had this season. And so we continue to try and grow our corporate sponsorship base. And it's more than just a sign on the Asher board or a feature on the Young One of Megatron. What we really try to do is partner with them. And it's called, we call it activation. And you notice this with teaming up with the lottery. And your non-winning lottery ticket is good for a discount at the box office. And Pepsi was kind enough to give us the side of their Pepsi cans for a 6-week period. And Shea Weber, we put his image on there and he gave everybody a $6 discount and brought that can to the box office. And I can continue to go through more of these examples, but hopefully what you see is the primary goal is filling the bill. And we want to take our partners that contribute to the success of our organization and create ticket-selling programs for them. So it's a win for the partner, it's a win for the fans, and it helps us build a better hockey team. The third point I'll make, and it's the last one, this is where I start to finish here, is our broadcast partners at Fox Sports Tennessee. They went from, they had 5 more games to last year's schedule, and they're going to add another 5 this year. And all those games really mean nothing unless you have an Emmy award-winning crew. We can grow you to 6 and on like that. And hopefully see that we're using sponsors and broadcast partners to fill the building so we can take that revenue and give it back to David so he can create a better team for Barry so we can bring the Cup down Broadway.
Years ago, and thank you to all of you for doing that as well. We're enjoying a great time right now. The rest of the summer is going to be strong. We just put the meeting plans up on sale, and business could not be better on the hockey side. And the arena side, as Tom said, we're starting to get to our goal of becoming the premier sports and entertainment facility in all of America. Last year, we finished, I think, sixth in the country. I should say, I know. This year, the rankings just came out for the first half, and we're pacing at the ninth busiest venue in America right now. Last year, at the same time, we were pacing at 23rd, and we finished sixth. Our second half this year is going to be just as strong, and we're really starting to approach that goal. The other thing we need to do to really achieve that goal, though, is to bring new personality into the building. And that's on the concourse. So that's to take the passion that's in our stands, that's out on Broadway, out on the plaza, and really engage with people when you walk through the building. And bring to life the great game we have on the ice and on the stage, up on the clean walls that we have up there. We need to change things around our food and beverage operation, our merchandise operation, and continue to improve things and put this building in a constant state of renovation to make it what you all deserve. And I just want to thank you all for coming out tonight, and more importantly, last season, and most importantly, for this coming year. Thank you.